Hey guys, doing a video for you on marigolds. It's so easy. First you want to start off, get your packet of seeds. These are Jaguar marigolds. I love these. Any type of marigolds, they look like this. Now you want to plant it vertically with that white part you see there facing down, the black part up. I just feel like they pop out of the soil just a little bit quicker. Get yourself a tote, whatever you're growing it in. I grow these all in my other veggie beds or my herb beds. I love them. They deter pests. They smell so good. Get them in the soil. Cover it lightly. Just sprinkle some soil on top of it. Don't press it down too much. Just make sure they're snuggled in there. And keep it in a sunny location and keep that soil wet. That's the main thing with germinating these. That soil has to stay pretty wet until they pop up out of there. Now, once they do get pretty big, this is a pretty big Jaguar marigold. This is probably about 3 months old, and that's pretty big for 3 months. The only nutrients that this has gotten in 3 months is one time. It was an all-purpose nutrients from Miracle-Gro. They come in little singles packets, and that's it. That's all I used. For bugs, these guys tend to get bugs, which that's why I keep them, because it kind of deters the bugs away from my cucumbers there. And that's why I use plants like this, just to deter them away from my good vegetables. You can see this nice fat cucumber underneath there, and that's just getting protected from bugs. And if you do get any bugs on your marigold, just check out my neem oil video, and that will take care of them. It's all organic. I love it. I use it on everything. My veggies, right on them. Just make sure you're washing them off real good, like anything you buy at the store. And then little buds are gonna start happening. Now, once your marigold has like two or three sets of leaves on it, start off and get in there. Get in there and pinch. Now, pinching method, let me see if I can zoom for you. You wanna get in there and pinch off at every node. So, like this top node right here, you want to go ahead and pinch that off. It's just whatever top growth is coming out. Just like that, I'll do another one for you. Like this center growth, just get in there, pinch it off, and that'll encourage branching. And you'll just get so many leaves. Look how big this is. I cannot even believe it. There are so many flower buds happening on it too. You can see. Now, when your flowers get like this, you want to cut them and enjoy them. If you're using it for the pest method, just leave a couple on there. And when you cut these off, you want to make sure you get it all the way down to that stem in there. Let me see if I can focus in. Just all the way down to the bottomest point you can find and give it a snip. And that's going to encourage new flowers to grow, new buds to form, branching out even more. You can see all them buds on her. And they smell so good. These are some more Jaguars. When they get kind of spent looking like that and kind of look done, then you can go and chop them off and, you know, discard them or just enjoy them for a few more days in some water. I just fill up a cup and plop them right in there. They stay good for a pretty good while. I love these Jaguars. And that's it, guys. They get really bright sun all day long. I started them outside. Just make sure wherever you're starting your seeds is where that plant will stay, just so you're not causing burning. You don't want to bring an inside plant, you know, directly outside in sun all day long. Just acclimate it slowly outside for about an hour each day, and that plant will be fine. Now, I wanted to show you what happens if you don't acclimate, just so this don't happen to you. You know, you get burning, you get kind of, the plant just looks ugly. It's too much heat for it. So just acclimate an hour each day slowly, and you'll be fine. These grow great indoors. They just don't get as big. These had grown indoors, and I acclimated them slowly out here, and you can tell they're fine. And they're starting to get big now. They really weren't too big. And I want to show you what a little birdie did. Look at this squash and marigold. Now, this is a garden I have neglected because we had a bad hurricane last year. And it kind of wiped everything out on me. So I just haven't gotten to it. And I left it because I noticed that these were marigold leaves. And look at this stem. Look how well these grow outside. And now when you grow these outside, you can cut this whole thing off and propagate this. Cut it off right at this bottomest point right here. Stick this whole thing either in soil or in water. I root them first in water and then I throw them in some soil. But you can, this will be a whole new plant and you can just enjoy that plant and that'll grow inside and be so happy. And you don't have to acclimate this too much. If you cut this off, it's like a cutting. So you're okay to go ahead and bring that inside. And then you can enjoy that flower too. And while you have it in the cup, new buds will even form on it. It's not going to stop the growth of the plant. It might stunt it a little bit, but it won't stop it. And just keep pinching. Keep pinching. Even when your plant gets big like this. I mean, look how big this is. A little birdie did it, and I just left it here. Look at this squash pumpkin. I don't even know what this is, guys. So I just want to encourage you. I haven't even given this nutrients, none of these. So you can see how green it's just growing by itself. I did hit it with a little neem oil just because, you know, you can see there's some weeds around it. I have to get in here and just clean it up. But that neem oil really helps to deter the pests. Look at all them flowers starting. Keep it really moist. They like to be really moist. Make sure your soil is not staying dry between waterings too much because this plant will end up wilting on you. Until next time, I hope that helped you guys.